Today we're making Frogger, a game where you play as a frog and your goal is to cross the road, and then you need to cross the river by jumping on logs. Because apparently frogs can't swim. Okay, let's go. Window. I don't want to stretch this part. Okay, here's our handsome looking frog. Let's put him in the game. Here's the frog class, and here's the draw function. Let's see. Oh my god, what did I forget this time? Oh. That wasn't so hard. Now we're gonna add controls. The frog will jump from one place to another, so we'll move it by the cell size. Let's test it. Yeah, I think we should make it a little slower. In order to fix this, we need to move the frog only once when the key is pressed. So along with checking the current state of the key, we're also gonna check the previous state. And it's working! Now we're gonna draw the map. We're not gonna bother with graphics for now, so we'll draw the map using squares of different colors. And since the columns in the Frogger map are similar to each other, we're just gonna change the cell's color based on its Y coordinate. Here's how it looks in the code. Now to make sure the frog doesn't feel lonely, let's add some other creatures. Like cars, for example. First I drew the car, then I made a class for it. The car will move either left or right based on the given direction. Oh yeah, that's how cool people drive. Let's add more cars. I made a new class which will control the cars, and will generate one car on each road. Let's see. What the hell? I don't know why, but for some reason the compiler refuses to acknowledge this line of code unless I put it in the draw function. And now it's working. Now we're gonna add warping to the cars so that they don't leave the map. I've already explained how warping works in my Pac-Man video, so go watch it if you're interested.
Another suck in the slope forever!
Okay, now we're gonna add more types of cars. We have two regular cars, two race cars, a truck, and a bus. If you think they look ugly, well, you're right. But that's not the point. Cars now have a new variable which will store their type. And since some types of cars are bigger than others, I also added a size variable. And we're gonna read the texture differently based on the direction the car is facing. Alright, this is looking good. Since we have different cars, they should also have different speeds. And here's how we're gonna achieve that. Okay, we're done with the road. Now we're gonna give the cars the ability to kill the frog. I used this amazing function provided by SFML to check whether or not the car is intersecting the frog. And if that function returns true, we're gonna set the frog to be dead. Thankfully, I've never seen a dead frog, so I'm gonna assume they look like this. Let's see if it works. Should I be happy or not? Okay, we're finished with the basics. Let's move on to the next step. The first thing we're gonna add is drowning. As soon as the frog reaches the river, it'll die. Okay, let's see if it- whoops. Okay, let's see if it drowns. Yay! Now to give the player a chance to win this game, we're gonna add logs. Logs come in three different sizes. Short, medium, and long. Since logs and cars will behave similarly, I just copied the code from one to the other. Alright, we have our first log. In order to have more logs, I made a new class called River Manager. Then I put a bunch of logs on the river. But having a bunch of logs doesn't mean anything if you can't stand on them. So let's change that. Similar with cars, we're gonna check the collision using the intersects function. And if the frog is not standing on any of the logs, we're gonna kill it. I also made the hitbox of the log smaller than the log itself to make sure the frog couldn't stand on it like this. Okay, we can stand on the logs, but the frog is not moving with them. I'm pretty sure that's not how physics works, so let's fix it. The log will move the frog in the same direction it's moving when the frog is standing on it. Alright, the logs are finished. It's time we add turtles. Turtles will move similar to logs, except they can go underwater. And if the frog happens to be standing on them, it'll go underwater with them, which will lead to its death. Here's how the turtle looks normally, and here's how it looks underwater. Instead of throwing turtles of different sizes, we'll just throw a certain number of them. Okay, we have turtles. Now in order to make them go underwater, we're gonna set a timer. And when the timer runs out, we're gonna change the state of the turtles. Then we'll restart the timer. I'm standing on the turtles, they go underwater and I'm dead. Cool. Now we're gonna add the last creature, the crocodile. Here's our amazing looking crocodile.
It's ugly.
You're ugly.
It's like...
Now we didn't want to make a whole new class for just one creature, so I decided to use the log class instead. We're just gonna check the collision differently when the log is a crocodile.
Damn, that's such a weird thing to say.
Okay, we finished the river. Now let's add a winning condition. This part of the map is supposed to be a swamp, and it has 5 empty spots. To complete the level, the player must get into each spot. Here's how the frog will look like in the swamp. I made a new array which will store the current state of the swamp. And if there's a frog in the swamp, we'll draw within the draw map function. Okay, let's see if it-
damn it.
Okay, let's see if it works. And it's not working! What a surprise! Okay, so the problem was we were drawing the cells on top of the frogs. And after quickly fixing it, the game is working. Now we need to add more levels. I used this website to understand how the levels in the original Frogger worked. Basically, the game will have 8 levels. After the player finishes the last level, we'll send them back to level 4. Then we'll make them play levels 4 through 8 forever. The manager classes now have a new function which will generate levels based on the given level index. Now we need to somehow finish this level. Almost. Thank God it worked. The last thing we need to add is a timer. We're gonna decrease the duration of the timer after each level. Alright, now that we finished with the gameplay, it's time to... We're gonna start with the map. Here's our new better looking tile set. I also improved the swamp frog. And as you can see, the game is already looking a lot better. Some of you might have noticed that I changed the ugly looking purple road into a sidewall. I figured it fits better with the road. Now we're gonna work on the cars. Out of all these cars, drawing the truck was the hardest thing I've ever done. And I'm still not satisfied with how it turned out. Okay, the road is finished. Now starting with the river, things will get a little more complicated. First I improved the locks. Then I drew this little animation for the crocodile. After that I wrote a simple animation code. And now the crocodile doesn't look like a floating doll anymore. The next thing on our list is turtles. Here's our texture. We're gonna move the sprite horizontally to animate the swimming, and vertically to animate the diving. Since we need to use the ping pong animation for the diving, I slightly modified the diving code for the turtles. I'm kinda proud of myself with how it turned out. The last thing we need to improve is the frog itself. Here's the jumping frames, and here's the standing frames. The frog now has a new variable for the current direction it's facing. When the frog jumps, we'll show the frame of jumping for a short period of time and then switch to the frame of standing. Now for the frog's death, I drew two versions. The first version is when the frog is killed by a car. The second is when the frog drowns. Alright, now the frog can die properly. Now the only thing left to add is text. For the timer, and for the level transition. And the game is finally finished. Woohoo! The code is in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And one last thing.